ఫోన్ కావాలనుకో.
Okay guys, so let's start today's session. So today we'll be finishing off the Flutter session. So we'll look at the code that we have written in the last session. I'll share the screen in a minute. I think we still have people coming in.
Yeah, Aditya, are you able to share screen?
Yes, I'm trying to share my screen, yes. So are you guys able to look at my screen? So this is the app that we have started last week. We are currently displaying all the items in a widget. So yeah, we'll do the same thing, but we'll try to organize things much better. Let's go to Dribbble for some UI inspiration. So we've finished so far. So this is the app that we've finished so far. So first we have a screen, the home screen. In the home screen, we are actually collecting the details where we have roll number, we have name, we have company placed in, we have company working for, we have higher education details, we have package, we have an email. So we are collecting all these details. To collect all these details, we are just using text field. So for each text field, we have a controller, an individual controller. This controller is used to control the text of the text field. So when this button is being pressed, so we are taking the text and creating a new student object and sending the student object to the student details screen. So this is the student details screen. Here we are implementing we actually have to implement some good UI, good looking UI, so that we can work on something. Yes. So I feel this kind of suits our need. So I want to download this file so that we can do this. Let's have a screen design here. And now our goal is to develop this kind of screen here. So if we see, we don't actually have an app bar here. Or we have an app bar, but this app bar is not actually visible. So we'll change some parameters in the app bar. So here, if you guys can see, in this app bar, there is some shadow in between, at the bottom. The reason why we are seeing the shadow is because it is elevated. So let's decrease the elevation to zero. So we set the elevation to zero. It should change. What else we need to change? We need to change the color of it. So now we effectively removed the color. Abar, but the abar is still present, but it's just that both the colors are same. So yes, let's continue. So in the body, we actually have the abar and the body together. So what we need to do is we'll remove the app bar entirely. Let's remove the app bar entirely and put one so what we'll do is we'll divide the entire screen into two parts. There are two parts here. the one which is at the behind, which is the pink color card, and on top of it there is another card. So what we'll do is we'll use a card here, we'll use a stack here. So if you use stack, so I'll show you the documentation of stack. So stack is used whenever you want to place a widget, one widget on top of another widget. So it's like this, yeah. So there is a green, there is a red color widget on top of the red color widget. There is a blue color widget on top of blue, on top of green. There is a blue color widget. So in the similar way, we have two types of two widgets. On top of this pink color widget, we have a white color card. So yeah. Widget get. So we are having a body here. So let's. Let's create a new method, get stack. This will return a widget. This will return a new stack. A stack will always have two children. I mean, it can have any number of children, but stack must have children. So in this stack, first we need to put the background widget. Okay. So we'll call get background method. And let's implement this method. And after this, we'll get foreground widget. So we have divided the screen into two widgets. One is the background widget, one is the foreground widget, according to our design. Okay. So let's first try returning text here. So now we have two widgets both on top of each other, both as a stack. So we cannot see those widgets because they are not centered. So let's first center them so that we can look at what exactly is happening. So if you guys can see, first the letter, first the text background was drawn. On top of it, the letter foreground is drawn. So, but we don't need text here. We need widgets which have these widgets. So we'll only build till here. So we'll only build till here. So all these widgets we are not going to build because it is not a part of it. So we'll only try to build till here. Everything which is on top of here, on top of this. So yeah. So first we need to build the background. In the background, we have a card. So let's say we have a card. Card color of the card is color start some pink. Not pink actually. We need to give a child to this, so we'll give a new container in empty container. So we have a pink box. We have a pink card. If you guys can see, there is a white color border to this card. This is because every card has a default margin. Okay, so I'll put the default margin to zero on all sides. If we want, we can put zero on one side and some other thing on other side. So we'll do that. We can do that by giving only. We don't want anything on the left. We don't want anything on the left. We don't want anything on the right. We also don't want anything on the top as well. So we'll put something on the bottom. So bottom will give eight. Okay, 80 is not enough. Let's get to 80. Okay. How about 80? We can also do this. There is another way to give bottom padding. So the other way is we can wrap this card with a column widget. If you guys remember, in a column widget you will have two widgets. So one widget will be the card, and the other will give just an empty container to fill up the space. So we can divide the whole screen into two parts. So now, since we have a column and a card, what we can do is we can remove this container, or we can put just put all zero. We can just put all zero, and now what happened is this container is taking all the space, so there is no space for the pink accent container. So we need to make sure that these two cards are not competing for space. For that, we'll wrap these widgets with expanded. Expanded is another widget. I'll explain it in detail now in a minute. So what we can do is we can give flex parameters to the X expanded. So once we give flex, so it will divide the entire screen in the ratio of the flex. Okay, so what actually happened is there are two widgets, a card widget and a container. So both these widgets are wrapped with expanded, and both widgets have an equal flex, which is one. So what Flutter does is Flutter will actually calculate the entire flex that was given, and using that it will give the ratios. So for example, if we give two here, the screen will be divided into three parts, and one part will be given to the container, and two parts will be given to this container. So we'll divide it into seven parts and give 5 and 2, or 5 and 3. This looks better, I guess. Or 6 and 4, about 6 and 4. 40%, 60%. Yes. So let's change the color first. So we have pink 100. Okay. So try this color. Actually, more close to pink. Yes. So we have the background widget ready. So all we need to do is we need to create the foreground widget. Okay, so now the background is ready. So let's work on the foreground part. So now if you guys can see, the foreground text is placed at the top of the screen, because this stack, the second widget on the stack, it will be placed at 0.0. So this is 0.0. So let's center this widget, try to center this widget. Okay. So now we have centered this widget. Now let's try to convert this text into card. So this is a card. Now if we wrap this card with a container, this will expand. So now we need name, we need UI UX, we need very passionate, we are passionate about creating beautiful. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll create the container with height. We'll give size to the container, height. I will give it a height of 200. Okay. Or we can also give it a height of 50. Let's try to 50. Yes. U20 maybe. Yes, better. So we'll work on borders again. So first let's fix the content first. So the child widget. So we are just have a child now. We need a row here, guys, because we need to display everything one after the other. So we'll just wrap this with a row. So we have name here. So name is student dot student dot name. So the orientation should be, if you guys remember, we need to we need a column. Sorry, I'm sorry. We need a column so that we can put one below the other. The row places this in a vertical order. So we have name here. So let's give name style. Font size will give 20. Yes, 24 looks good. Style. Font weight. Font weight dot bold. Okay, so we need to provide a bit of padding here. After padding. Yes, so that there is some padding at the top of it. So we'll put some additional padding to the text widget only at the top. Okay, so now here we need another text widget. The text will be widget dot student dot company presently working for. We'll put company presently working for. Present company. We'll change the style again. First, we'll put some padding at the top of it. Let's put some padding. Let's increase the size. Style. In the style, new text style. Font size is 18.0. So font weight W200. Yes, I think we should decrease the font size by 1. This looks better to me actually. So now we need to add, we are passionate about creating. So we'll put the education details here, higher education details here. Since this is the same style, we'll put higher education details. Let's put some text. Some more padding for this. So what else? So we have a follow button here. So we'll put a follow button there here as well. So hypothetically, if our application has a follow feature, so we'll just put a follow button. So new, do we have a rounded button in Flutter? We'll see. Raised button, onPress will have some onPress. We need an on raised button. So raised button shield would be new container with color dot yellow. Let's see, okay. Color start yellow. Yes. Do we have shape here? Yes. Oof. So let's put some padding on top of this raised button. Only top. Okay. So let's give this a child text. Our text color in this case should be white, is it? So yes, so let's give it a style. New style. I think this is not pure white. Oh, let's keep it white. Okay, moving ahead, we have two other widgets here. So one followers and other following. So what all did we use? We've put name. We've kept name. The name is done. Company is done. So we have an email address and package. We will put package and roll number here at the bottom. This should look better. Yeah, we'll put package and roll number. So this package and roll number are placed side by side. So to place any two widgets side by side, we need a row. Okay. So before the row, we actually have a small line. So to put a line, we need a divider widget. If you guys can see, we got a divider widget. Okay. So we need a row here. In the row, we need two children. I'll just put two texts first. This should be package student dot package. Widget student Okay. Now we need to align these two widgets properly. So again, to equally divide the space we have, to divide the space we have equally, we'll use expanded again. So we'll wrap this widget with an expanded widget. Wrap this widget with an expanded widget. So if you want to divide the space equally, you don't have need to give any flex. If you don't give any flex, that by default the way the size will be divided equally. So now we'll center this widget. Very good. So we'll put some padding on the top of the row. Oops, only in the top. We actually need titles as well about the roll number and package. So in place of text, we need to wrap this text with a column so that we can add one more title to it. So I'm just wrapping this text widget with a column. So here I will add a new text widget which says roll number. Here I will wrap this with a column and I'll call this text widget as package. Yes. So we need some space in between these two things as well. We'll put padding for this text widget only. So let's give this text some style. So the roll number should be of almost same size as UI UX, right? So this we gave it style, this style. So we see an error because we ran out of space. Instead of giving this card a particular size, that foreground widget, we have a column. Foreground widget. We have a card, right? We have a container. So we gave it a height. We'll just remove the height. So this should give it as well. Oh, it is taking in the entire height. Okay, so we'll give it 300. Okay. Later we can reduce this width as well. Now the roll number is fixed. Yes, you can use media query as well. I don't usually use media query because media query is really expensive widget. Because when you use media query every time and do complex calculations, as I've explained in the earlier videos, the Flutter has to render its views every 16 milliseconds. So if you are using media query, it won't be very smooth. Actually, we can remove this container actually. So if we remove this container, this will occupy all the space. So that is the reason we have a container which will only occupy the space that we gave it. Let's increase the text size of roll number. You need to reduce the color of yellow, yes. Yellow 700 it is. Yes. Now it is more pleasant. Okay. So let's reduce the roll number stick size to 22. So we need to use the same style here. So I'll just copy the center widget and paste it there. We'll have to replace it with package and package in lags, right? Here we need to put package. So here it is. I think this is not. This is some shade of orange. Let's try looking at the color now. She's looking better now. So yeah, so we need to fix other few other things. We need to add a border radius to these cards. So we'll do that. So here's a card. So shape. Detect on the border. Border radius dot circular. Border radius dot only bottom left. We'll give it 15.0. Bottom right. We'll give 15.0. This needs a radius. Okay. Yes. So now we have this cut set at the bottom. Now let's try to increase it to 60. Oops. Let's go back to 20. Very good. Perfect. So we'll copy this shape and use the same shape of the foreground widget. But instead of only, we need to use all, because we need a radius on all sides. Yes, even for the bottom, even for the top widget, we have radius. But if you guys can see, we have a bit of shadow here. We don't have much shadow here. So we'll increase the elevation. We'll put the elevation to 32. Get maximum elevation. Yes. So that's it, guys. So in around 40 minutes, I guess, we have almost did this beautiful looking UI. If we can access this image, we can also put that image here. We can on top of the card, we can actually put the image widget. So we can wrap the card widget with a row. Let's try to do that as well. Rupesh, do we have time? We have 10 more minutes. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so let's try to do that as well. So I'll remove the center widget. Now this card will go to the top. Let's put the wrap widget with let's wrap the widget with a column. So new icon. Okay, so the cross-axis element for the cross-axis for the column is the vertical axis, the horizontal axis. So we'll put cross-axis element as center. It's not working. Yes, so we almost got the same type of UI without the image. So if we want to increase this the background card a bit, we can do that as well. And now we just gave it 4 and give it 5 6. So that's it, guys. So I think I hope everyone followed my tutorial. If you guys have any doubt, you can ask me. We actually used most of the widgets that any Flutter developer would normally use, and this is the nested tree structure. So I hope everyone is clear with this. So I will be sending the entire source code to the to Rupesh. So Rupesh will probably put it in a Git repository. Could you please show me how you sent and used student details? I missed previous session. Definitely, yes. So if you want to do another screen, it is really simple in Flutter. You just need to create an object. And whenever you are creating a new screen using navigator, so here I am using navigator.push to go to next screen. So here I am passing the student as a parameter to the widget, the student details screen. Here I am putting it here at the top of my widget. Now in my widget, whenever I want to use this student object, I can directly access it using widget.student. The student widget I can directly access by calling widget.student. If it is a stateful widget, you need to call widget.student, but if it is a status widget, you can directly access it. Yes, you can pass those values to multiple screens. So for example, if you are going to an X screen from here, you can again pass these values. It is totally up to you. Yeah, Rupesh, I think we can end this now.